So as you can see, I'm with WGA's Brian Howard. How are you, Brian?
I'm all good, thank you very much.
So you're here today to launch the AIB Future Sparks Festival, which is on in the RDS in the 14th of March. So some of the leading figures from Irish technology, social innovation, music, sport and business, they're going to be speaking at the event, which is now in its second year with over 7,500 senior level students descending upon the RDS for an event which will bring together business leaders and young entrepreneurs to inspire students and show them the power of their potential. When it comes to young entrepreneurs, when it comes to business leaders, you're in a business degree yourself, I think, Brian?
Yeah, I'm in my third year of a business studies degree in DIT, and I'm actually very excited to meet some of the future entrepreneurs of the future, and it's a great way to learn from them, and I'm not too much older than them. But yeah, it's a good way to know and get their insights into what they want to do, and maybe I could learn from them as much as they can learn from me.
Is there a particular area of business you're actually interested in, or is it just at the moment keeping your feet down and surveying everything at your disposal?
Yeah, I'm sort of keeping all my options open, but at the moment I'm sort of focusing towards the marketing aspect of business, which I don't know where that would bring me, but yeah, my course now, it branches off into different things if you want it, so I think I'll be going down the marketing route, but who knows.
Yeah, the world's your oyster, I guess.
Exactly.
I'm sure one of the things that people are going to be asking you about is a lot of kids here, and like one of the big questions is when you finish up school, the work-life balance or the study-life balance as it is for a lot of Leaving Cert students, which is obviously something you've had to deal with yourself throughout your Dublin career, throughout your school days. Is there anything that first comes off your mind into the importance of having something like football on the side when you're studying?
Yeah, I know I put huge focus on trying to maintain both of them, because I know some students neglect the sporting aspect, or whether it's just exercise in general, just getting out and clearing the head, and I use that as a great way of releasing stress, and I'd focus set aside whether it was 2 hours a night or whatever it was to just release it a couple of times a week, just to release all the stress and focus. And when I'm down there, I just didn't think about school, didn't think about exams. So now I was playing minor when I was doing my Leaving Cert. So it was difficult and it was challenging, but the reward at the end, just to go down with your friends, and then you can get back, clear the head for the next day and get to bed early.
Yeah, for sure. Can you talk to us a little bit about what your day at the moment is, your typical day? I know you're obviously in third level, so every day is kind of different when it comes to lectures. So say when you're in college on a Tuesday or on a Wednesday, is it strenuous? Is it high octane stuff and then trying to get to training straight away after college?
There's obviously a bit of balance that you have to do, and it is difficult to get, I know I'm studying DIT, so to get out to where we're training, it is difficult when it's rush hour traffic. But now it's obviously when you wake up in the morning, you have to go in early, you do your exams, and there is breaks. College, it's a nice time of your life. From my experience, that there is gaps, and you can fit in your food, you can fit in socialising through lectures, because it's not too strenuous at the moment. But maybe in fourth year might change. But at the moment it's not too strenuous, and I could have a bit of leeway leaving lectures and just catching up by asking a few of the lads or the girls in the course just to pass on the notes. So that's what I do.
I want to talk a little bit about your hopes for this year, but we should touch on 2018. It wasn't a bad year for you, Brian, was it? Like at the start of the year, if you were told that you were going to become a starter consistently for Dublin and an All-Star and an All-Ireland winner, you probably would have taken that.
Oh yeah. Obviously last year was an amazing achievement for me. At the start of the year when I set out, so I just wanted to say to my parents, I sat them down at the start of the year and friends, and just said I'd love to get a bit more game time than the previous year because I didn't get too much. And then just kept rolling, and I became more confident. And when Jim gave me the start against Kildare in the first game, from then on I just became more confident and kept developing and getting better and better. And then it just tumbled away from me then. And
like, how big a thing was that for you, that confidence? Because obviously one of the things that was played out quite a bit in the media was two great young players last year, yourself and David Clifford, and it seemed the two of you kind of thrived under the pressure and under the spotlight. But that obviously gave you a lot of confidence that under that spotlight you were playing so well.
Yeah, obviously David Clifford, phenomenal player, and I know he's going to be a great addition when he comes back in with Kerry. But no, there was no external pressures. I knew what I had to do, and at the end of the day, the All-Stars and awards, they're obviously nice to get, but it's not the main focus. Our focus as a team was to get the Sam Maguire again and get our hands on it, and thankfully we did that.
How big a help was it having Brian Fenton there?
Brian, he's from day one, I've always said it, he's a great role model of mine. He was helping me from day one, bringing me to training and telling me how to go about it, what's right and what's wrong, how to go about things. So having him there was a great help, and just the whole culture of the team, it's very welcoming. I know my first session when I went in, from then on I knew I was just one part of the team because they were coming over, they were giving me advice, they were welcoming me in and having a crack from day one. So that helped a lot, and it's not a coincidence that a lot of the new lads come up have developed on to be great players because the transition from whether it's your club coming in, it's not too difficult because it's just such a great bunch of lads.
It's Brian Howard speaking with you yesterday, having the crack.
Yeah, he's enjoying his football, I dare say, at the moment, which is, okay, is it possible? I certainly wouldn't be one of those people who'd be able to enjoy being somebody going for five in a row. The pressure would definitely grind me down, but it seems this particular set of Dublin players are well suited to it.
Really, you wouldn't like to be an elite athlete at the peak of your powers, about to make history?
Well, maybe
you wouldn't find that an enjoyable thing.
Maybe
really?
If I was
going
to play for Dublin, the confidence would come with that as well.
Okay, let's bring you part two, the second half of our chat here with Brian Howard. Have a look.
It's an interesting enough sporting environment as well that you come from. I think with so many of the Dublin players, there's different sports that people feed into, like Michael Darren McCauley and his basketball, Brian and his swimming past,
yeah.
And like Raheny as a whole. Like, it was a great year for Raheny footballers, but like Nick Clossy in the marathon last year and all that. It's been a great little sporting environment. Was it always GAA for you?
No, I went to St. Fintan's High School out in Sutton, and it was a very sporty school. There was a lot of sports. I played soccer, basketball, rugby. Loads of different sports. So, but my heart always was in the Gaelic. I know I played a lot of rugby during school, and I went on to play a bit more. But now my heart was always in the Gaelic. But there's so much you can learn from rugby, the physicality, and then obviously the basketball, the hand-eye coordination, the movement, and that's developed me to be the player I am today.
What position did you play in rugby?
I was second centre.
Right, okay.
13, yeah.
Bit of a Brian O'Driscoll.
Yeah, maybe not as good as him though.
You talk about like some of the things that you can learn from other sports, and it was funny, I was actually going to ask you about that because we saw Johnny Cooper in the off-season going with Leinster Rugby, and he went with Saracens for a while as well just to pick up a few things from them. Has there been any of that on your own individual level in terms of self-improvement? Because I know you always have like a month or two just to yourself before you go back in with the Dubs to actually focus on yourself and self-improvement.
Yeah, but I didn't focus really on any other sports, really,
sure.
Other than just fitness. I know my school was big into the athletics, and other than that, there wasn't really much that I picked up on the off season. I just went after my preparation in terms of, I knew it's going to be a tough year ahead as I'm saying with the league so competitive. So I sort of just getting into the right mindset of what's going to be challenging us this year.
Yeah, for sure. It's mad when you think about Raheny footballers. Is there a gene that makes you so good at high fielding, or is there something in particular? Because like people talk about your catch in whatever the 74th minute against Tyrone last year, kind of reminiscent of Brian Fenton. A lot of what he does is reminiscent of Kieran Whelan.
Yeah, no, I know I've heard that before. There must be something in the water in Raheny, but no, I think just the juveniles in Raheny is well established, and people put a lot of focus on that right down from the Oga under fives all the way up. There's a great support and background. I know new chairman now, Colin Codd, he sort of has stuff in place, and for the likes of the senior members going down in any club, the effect that a senior member has on the younger kids, whether it's coming down watching a game of football or watching them play or taking a training session, it's infectious for the team. And it is, it's to hear a new voice. I know Raheny are trying to bring it in, getting just the interaction between different levels more powerful. And it's something that hopefully, because I know when I was young, having Kieran Whelan come down, it was magical for me to just hear a new voice and someone that's been through it all. And he's won medals and have lost some big games. But hearing him and coming down, sharing his knowledge, and it's really developed the club. And I know myself and Brian and like Sean McMahon, who've been around the Dublin squad, are trying to develop that interaction between juveniles and seniors in the club.
Yeah, it's great. It's a remarkable attitude to have, to not get totally caught up in what you're doing and to actually think about your legacy, which is ultimately what's the club going to look like after I finish playing.
Yeah, because if it wasn't for Raheny, where I started off, we wouldn't be anywhere really. So there is huge credit. And I know myself and Brian and as all the other lads on the team love going back to playing with the club because there's a different atmosphere. I know when the Dublin team's great and all, but when you come back to the club, the lads that you've literally grown up with, you hang around with, the friends they've been through, all sort of stuff with, not on the field and off the field, it's very good to go back and be able to play games with them. I know we would like to play probably a bit more games with Raheny, but the way it falls, we just don't get the opportunity. But when you do go back for a championship, it's a great time of the year.
Yeah, it's funny you say that. I was going to ask you about playing more games. I know we've got an off week in the National Football League this weekend. How is the body feeling? I know you're playing Sigurdsson Cup this year. You did play a couple of Sigurdsson Cup games this year. A bit of an extra workload. Did you feel the extra workload?
No, I haven't felt it because obviously I'm young now and I just want to keep playing matches. But now the body feels great. It's brand new at the moment. So, there's obviously a lot of games coming up and I've gone past. But Sigurdsson, it was a tough, it's a great competition. It's a tough competition, so there is demands in that regard. But when you're going back to Dublin, they don't expect you to be training maybe every night when you're playing a game. Obviously they wouldn't expect you to play the night before if you had a Sigurdsson game next day, so it is managed. But it is tough, but now I feel brand new.
Yeah, like the reason why I asked obviously was like whatever it was 12, 13 months ago at this stage, you decided to put all your eggs into the Dublin basket, which didn't turn out too badly. Yeah. It always just seems that it's such a great competition, but ultimately there's just a little bit too much going on for young footballers at that time. Is that something you'd agree with, or do you think the calendar's actually fine?
I think the calendar's grand at the moment and it seems to have worked. The likes of Darren Gavin who had it, and Kane O'Connor who've had tremendous performances with UCD, and they've came straight in and started yesterday against Roscommon. But I think if you like, because it's such a high quality competition and you're playing against the best players all over the country that are still in college, I think it is a great way to get a foothold into yourself in terms of you can build confidence from playing Sigurdsson. And then if you're playing well, he'll give you the opportunity. So if you come off the back of a good Sigurdsson campaign, you'll get the opportunity with inter-county level.
Final question then, Brian. What's your best position?
I'll take anywhere I'm given, but I know I like anywhere around the middle eight. So just once I'm playing, I'm happy.
Yeah, that's vague enough to get you a starting jersey for the Dubs, I think. Brian Howard, great to catch up. Thank you very much. Thank you.